David Lenson, he wrote a fantastic book about the phenomenology of altered states. He wrote a book about what it feels like from the user perspective, from the inside, when one is having an experience of heightened qualitative intensity. And one of the hallmarks of his writing was this idea that the person who deploys an altered state wants to take control of his or her consciousness at any given moment. What is disliked must be avoided, and what is enjoyed can be enjoyed with contemplative exactitude. Now, what this means is that one takes upon a kind of stewardship of internal life. One takes upon a kind of cinematic sensibility or a cinematic responsibility. The idea is that the altered state, the trip, is a dramatization of the way that we string together fragments of experience. And so the trip becomes a film. The trip becomes something to be authored in real time. So the idea is that if you're a filmmaker, you're really a trip maker. What it means to be a filmmaker is to be a trip maker. Take control of your mind screen, take control of your movie, stewardship of internal life. And that's why the heuristic, the 1969 phrase of dismissal, "get out of my movie," signifies this increased stewardship of internal life. The responsibility, the realization of the creative possibilities inherent in every moment to take control of your mind screen, to go from filmmaker to trip maker, is to finally inhabit one's own mythic life. One becomes the music maker and the dreamer of dreams of one's own experience. And that is liberation. You know, not someone else's dogma, not someone else's poetry turned into your scripture. Oh no, you are responsible for the template of meaning of your life. Your mythic life is yours to create. Never forget it. Stewardship of internal life. And anyone who gets in the way of that, any fucking corrupt guru who tries to impose his interpretive frameworks upon you with a kind of moral authority, this is what you do. You tell him, "Get out of my movie. Get out of my movie."